the letter goes on to do kind of a academic analysis of how art is being used in non-art academic projects. And it just ends. Agnes, I'm not sure how I got here. Will my art practice work as sociological research, or will sociology become my art? Whose clothes am I trying on? Yours, Lois. Okay, and this one I just finished, so May 2018. And it's a little bit longer, so you might need to look at pictures while I'm reading. Dear Agnes, in Kingston, blood in thick droplets hangs like unfinished grief in the air where sumacs fill in unclaimed gullies and riverbanks. The sumacs grow at the base of highway off-ramps and in the unmanicured drainage basins near suburban housing and near the hidden quarries that people swim in illegally next to Highway 15. This letter, the last one I'll write before my enrollment at Queen's comes to an end, is an attempt to acknowledge a situation and a place. Given all that's gone on since I first started, it seems to me that this place is undergoing an unmapping. Shireen Razak describes it this way. Unmapping is intended to undermine the idea of white settler innocence, the notion that European settlers merely settled and developed the land, and to uncover the ideologies and practices of conquest and domination. I'm writing to you, Agnes, because you seem to be the best person I know to ask this. How much are we clothed in innocence, and how worn are the maps we follow? While writing and while imagining your ghostly ears listening to my self-narration while I pass in and out of buildings in Cataraqui, Kingston, Agnes, I feel like I've grown to know you. Mostly the familiarity is bred in your house, the Etherington House and the Agnes Etherington Arts Center, referred to as the Agnes. Also your family, the Richardsons, which the Queen's Encyclopedia describes as a Kingston and Queen's dynasty, is familiar as the family behind the grain empire, which during my childhood erected Winnipeg's first skyscraper at the corner of Portage and Main. The Richardson building is a place that in my childhood imaginary was monumentally, though in fact only distantly, linked to the grain that my father hauled in refurbished one-ton grain trucks from his fields to nearby elevators.